Today, I'm welcoming Gabriela in my quest phase of getting to know different terms in the world of possibility management. And we decided to talk about the term of box. Box has appeared in some of my previous videos already. And now I really want to dive into what does it mean in the world of possibility management? What does it mean in the world of Gabriela? How do you experience it and how do you work with it in theory and practice?
Thank you, Anja, for bringing that into this space. I want to start saying that box was one of the terms inside of the world of possibility management that most call my attention at first moment and get time to I get it in all my bodies. Because a distinction and distinction that you receive, if you not experience this distinction, become just a concept. So if you take the distinction of feeling and emotion, or the distinction of box and being, and you're not really experiencing it in your life, this thing that I speak here will be a concept to you. And we have a lot of concepts. So the difference is when you take this idea, this concept, and you experience by yourself. So one of the invitations that I let to you and to who is watching this video is to really experiment whatever we will talk here. This is my first invitation.
So is it really like to take the three letters BOX as a bridge from some brain construct into real life and experiencing it? And maybe then just leaving the term away and experiencing the background of it.
Yes. Mm. The word box is or any another distinction is these doorways, this gateway to you access the experience of something different, something possible. So the box, what possibility this word box give to me? The possibility that this word give to me was to disattach it, like I'm not that. And as soon that I could disattach it from this, I could have more space to move and to create. So in a really short way, everyone have a box, but you are not your box. Anyone are their boxes. I'm not my box. And in another world, box would be called by personality, ego. In the spiritual world, is a lot of called by ego, or identity, or belief system, or opinions. And this word box in possibility management take as this department, the survival strategy that you create to survive. So your being, you put your being inside of this box to survive. And this box is made by opinions, like or dislike. Like, I like black, I like red, I like cold, I don't like cold. And how many times you already have this kind of discussions with friends, for example, like, oh, I love chocolate, hot chocolate, and your friend, oh, I don't like it, so sweetie, oh my god, no, I prefer alcohol drink, wine. And it started this discussion like this, I like, I don't like. This is box conversation. Probably you already listened this term, box conversation. Is this like this structure that is the box is die, is a die mechanism you made in the past to survive, and it's with you protecting you because you are not initiated. We are not, the mother culture is not designed to initiate human beings when they naturally do 18 years old. So we keep the box as a survival strategy and not as a tool. So as I was saying, the box is the opinions, dislike, the beliefs, the old decisions, the now I'm missing the words, but it's everything that is componing this survival strategy mode. Memes, memetic constructs. So it's this huge territory of the survival strategy. And I really like this image of a box, a real box, like this up, down, and I'm inside. And there is this thing called expanding the box. That is the central training of possibility management, where it's 5-day training where you started to have this first initiation, receiving this starting point where you have the possibility to start to expanding your box, because you never will lose your box. This is an illusion of illumination in the spiritual world, that you don't have ego anymore when you illuminate it.
Yes. Yes, thank you. That brings me to a question that was flowing inside of me. Like if I work on my box to want to get rid of it, and you say we need the box or we have the box for survival, then there would right away be the thought, well, if I want to get rid of my box, I won't survive. And the way I understand you is like we are constantly trying to enlarge in our box. So we will still stay alive, but we will be much more flexible and have more space for creativity.
Yes. And what would be the purpose to get rid of the box?
It's a construct again.
Be perfect. If I get rid of my ego, my box, I will be perfect. At least for me was this sentence. In the beginning, I was so like, I don't want to have a box. My box is so, I don't want it because I might be in prison and nah. But the box is, it's could, as soon as you started to initiate it, it started to become a tool for you relate with the world. And is the purpose is not get rid of. Is to go into liquid states. To you expand your box and change parts of your box, you need to go liquid. So this is the purpose of the feeling. Because if feeling is bad, you not go liquid. And what does it mean be liquid? Being liquid is being this groundless space where everything that you believe, which means your box, are more flexible to scratch, to expand, to change. So this is the purpose of the liquid state, is for this transformational space happen.
So it's really like to melt down the walls of the box to be able to make, to push them a little further apart, and then they can get solid again for a while, and I can get used with this new stuff, and then I can go liquid again as a process. And I was thinking of your example talking about, I like chocolate. No, I like wine. And I'm constantly searching for somebody who says, oh, I like chocolate too. And then finally I feel at home. Somebody has a box that's just like mine. And when I enlarge in my box, I will be able to say, well, I feel shame to reveal that I like chocolate. And that's a total different topic than saying, I like chocolate. Would that be an example?
Yes. You could, when you share something, you are revealing your being. So you are invoking the another person being also. Because when you say, I like it, you don't like it. You are invoking this box war. It's like when people are talking about political opinions. Especially the mind. I know so much that because my mental body is so activated and I'm practicing how to use my other bodies to communicate in relating, especially when you go a lot of to mind, and mother culture is like trained so much us to speak, to be in the mind, in the mental body. It's so easy to go to this talking of box of things in the past. And through experiments that I've been doing, one of the ways that I discovered that is most powerful to not be in this box to box conversation is the fear.
Mm-hmm.
Is the unknown. Because you are in the edge of your box. Your box is what you know. So when you reconnect, fear is fear. Fear is not bad. Oh, it's okay if you fear. So I go to the ad and I'm freaking out. I'm in fear. But even that, I'm okay to be there. I'm okay to not say, I don't like chocolate. I'm okay to share, I feel fear to say you that I don't like chocolate and I want to try chocolate. Because I want to experience something that my box is not used with. I want to experience something new. So if it's okay if you fear, you have this whole vast possibility field to experience things that you never experienced before. That is out of, in modern culture, a lot of people say out of comfort zone.
Yeah.
It's new. And I, from this place, I want to share one experience of mine that I did that really shift for myself this box distinction. And if you feel called, I invite you to do this experiment by yourself. And the experiment is you decide one thing about your being. So you have your being and you have your box. And you create your box to protect your being during your childhood and adolescence. So you decide one thing about your being that you want to express into the world. Could be anything, could be authenticity, could be empowerment, could be beauty, aliveness, whatever. You decided what value you want to bring out into the world. And then you decide, or you ask for a 3-cell or your team, a character, identity to you, where you're being. So you have your box, which means you have your identity. And because you are not your identity, you can change identities. How often you were in a call, or you, some of your friend was in a call and was talk with you first, and then their mother, his mother called to them, to him. And then he take, like, he was talking like this, and then he take this cell phone and, hello, mother, how are you?
Different role.
Different role. It seems almost different person, right?
Different personality, yeah.
Different voice, different face, different expression. This is shifting identity, so unconscious actually, but like shifting. So this is shifting identity. And people already do this naturally, but unconscious. This experiment is about you do it consciously.
Mm.
So you ask for a person to say you a character that it's different from your identity, from your box. And you use this identity to do the action of your being. So for example, the identity that my 3-cell gave me in the gremlin transformation where I did this experiment was a powerful woman, a rich, powerful woman. And this identity is totally opposite of my box, because my box is really scarcity box. It's like, I don't have power. I'm don't want to appear. I don't want to get attention. I don't like get attention. I don't have money. This is one of the big blocks of my box. Like, I don't have money. So they give me this powerful woman, rich, that money is not a problem identity. And the action So you ask for your team also give an action. Through you can express this value. And the action that my team gave me was to take 300 reais, which are the Brazilian currency, exchanging little notes, like 2-5 reais, so then I could have a lot of money in my hand, go to a bus station, empowered people about money, and then throw away my money to the, like, throw away. And I'm telling laughing now, but I was totally in fear when they say that. Like, I will not do that at all, not. But I decided to do, and my main discovery during this experiment, so I dress up as a powerful woman. This is an important thing. So you dress up as this character because it helps you to enter in the new identity. And you, for example, if someone give you the pirate Jack Sparrow identity, you wear as a pirate. So you enter in this identity. And what I discovered was experiencing in myself that I'm not my box. Mm-hmm. And this was the first time that I could experience, because I heard in Exponent Box, in the trainings a lot, I'm not my box, I'm not my box. But in this moment that I was totally fear, talking with people in the bus station, like, if money is not a problem in your life, what you'd be doing right now? I was talking with them. And then when I throw away this money that for my box was, I can't do that because I don't have money. So how I will throw away money? Something shifted inside of me. And this something was this experience of, I'm not my box. And what this bring to me was a huge freedom. Freedom is a tricky word, but give me such a space to experience a lot of things. Because if I'm not my story of my childhood, if I'm not my emotions, if I'm not these belief systems that I grow up, the Catholic belief system, the school belief system, the mother culture belief system, my being have such more space to relate in the world and to express it.
Mm.
So this experience for me was this bodies, all bodies involved experience of this distinction of the box.
And I believe, thank you for that example. I believe somebody could do that. Like, okay, I'm going to do that. I'm going to dress up and I'm going to do that, and nothing shifts. Because it's also, that is so trained in us in this modern culture to do stuff that we are told to do and not really, really experience it. Slowing down. And how does that feel to be dressed up like that? How does it feel to hold this money? How does it feel when I really throw it away? I can just throw it away and narrow down my thinking and say, that's okay. Yeah. And then nothing shifts and it won't last. But the way you tell it makes me assume that you did it with a high consciousness, with a high level of awareness. What am I doing? How am I experiencing that? And then it could actually get into your cells and all your bodies.
Hmm. So, thank you for adding this dimension, Anja. Yes, there was, I think the important element when you experiment is the noticing and the feeling. So not numbing yourself. We are, one of the survival strategies is to numbing, to not feel. And I had a friend holding space for me, so I invited a friend to hold space for me during the experiment, to so then I could express my fear, because it was so much fear going on. Fear what people will think about me. And what if I get in prison, or people are looking to me, men's in the bus is looking to me. This is one of my fear, the hugest fear, like dressing like that, because I was dressing with short clothes and calling attention of men and like this. And this was totally my edge. So the feeling is what make the experience be experience. And not this, okay, I do that as a new assignment or the new homework.
Yeah, then I'm back in school.
Yes.
Yeah. Wow, thank you. So for me, it feels as if I want to take small steps. I want to do a new experience, but I want to take a small step. And if I do a big step, I will probably dissociate and not really be there. And then I'm numbing down and I can do that, but nothing shifts. So I guess it's very important if you want to expand your box to go slow steps and not overwhelm yourself.
I'm laughing because I am the kind of box that one of my survival strategies is doing a lot. And we call red brain. This red brain is a kind of brain that is do. So the way that I do the things of my box is do the things is these huge steps, this like this. And what I let for another kind of brains, like the blue brain or the dream brain, is to sense in yourself what is your next step. And maybe your next step is to talk with your mother using a warrior box. Maybe it's do the next training that you hold space or the next call that you will hold space. Being warriors, sorcerers, a witch. And
it could be even so small to say, okay, I will take the choice to go to the same bakery as always, but I'm going to buy a bread that I have never bought before. Such small step.
Yes. Anything that go out of the automatism, this usual thing, or you are going to your work and instead you go to the same way with your GPS, with your map, you take out the map and you let yourself go in a different direction.
Yeah.
Or if you drink the water with your right hand, you drink with your left hand.
Yes.
If you cook every day rice and beans, as Brazilians do, you eat, I don't know, avocado in the lunch.
Yeah.
So yes. This is could be a really tiny little experiments, expanding your box. And another thing that is coming now, an important thing inside of the box is the rules. So we create a lot of rules. The rules is another part of the box that I remembered.
We are already talking for about 20 minutes now, and still I have this one question. If you remember one of the earliest box expansions you have experienced, unconsciously and now remembering, or consciously, can you give us one example, maybe even before you met possibility management? Do you have a memory of some box expansion you experienced?
Mm-hmm. Before possibility management, the day that I cooked something with my mother without recipe. Like we found a cake, it was a chocolate cake with a ganache. And we did it without recipe. And for me, this was an expansion without I know that was expansion. And the most recently one was yesterday. I was with Lisa. We were in a doing nothing day. And it was my first time going to a sauna in Germany. And like seeing people naked, being naked and walking and entering. We were in that pool and outside was 1 degree. And I was in the water And for my box, like that is so, like the cold is so cold. 1 degree was so much, and I was in the water, and I was like, oh my God, are you frozen? And yeah, so this was for me a expansion, which means was totally out of my comfort zone, what my box used to do.
Yeah. Thank you for those two examples. Thank you for talking with me about box.
Thank you, Anya,
I
for
want
this.
to invite all who are listening to this to go small steps and just try out a little box expansion. Yeah.
Yes.
Thank you, Gabriela.
Thank you, Anya.